The Indian consulate in New York City hosted an event last week. They hosted an Indian delegation. And here is what happened at the event and what they had to tell our viewers.
High-level delegation which has come from India for assessing the problems of the Indian-American community, particularly in the consular areas, in order to see how these problems can be addressed. As you're aware, and as we have already indicated to you in the message that was sent welcoming you to this luncheon, Government of India is acutely aware and sensitive towards several of the issues which are agitating. There has been a continuous dialogue between representatives of the Indian American community and, of course, the Government of India, which also includes the representatives of this consulate. And in order to fast-track the process of finding solutions, the government has decided to mount this delegation, which will be visiting different cities where our consulates are located. Of course, they have started with New York because, for obvious reasons, New York merits primary consideration, and they are here with us. I'm very happy that you all have come here, because this would give you and them an opportunity to interact on a one-to-one basis about the issues which you have been raising with the Government of India, and also give them an opportunity to give you their assessment of how these problems are being addressed. So without more ado, I would like to once again welcome the delegation and request Mr. Ajay Chaudhary to address you briefly about the purposes and the mission of the delegation, and to then set the tone for whatever the other members of the delegation have to say. Let's see Mr. Ajay Chaudhary, please.
I think Prabhu has already mentioned everything about the purpose of our visit. I am very happy that all of you have really spared time on a Sunday to visit the consulate and meet us, because as Prabhu has said, Government of India attaches great importance to providing consular services in an efficient manner, and we learned that there were certain difficulties being faced by the Indian community in the United States, and therefore this delegation is visiting the New York, Houston and San Francisco, and we would be meeting the members of the Indian community to get to know firsthand what are the difficulties and how we could resolve the problems. So that is why we are here, and I have been listening to the problems being mentioned by several of you, and once we understand the problems, it would be our endeavor to streamline the processes so that consular services are provided in a very smooth and efficient manner. Thank you.
सारी दुनिया में जो वरिष्ठ नागरिक हैं, सीनियर सिटीजन्स, उनका खास ध्यान रखा जाता है. जो वहां से भारत से यहां पहुंचे, अब वो वरिष्ठ हो चुके हैं, सीनियर हो चुके हैं. उनके लिए कोई विशेष सुविधाएं ताकि वो आ जा सकें बिना रुकावट के, कोई ऐसा सरकार कभी सोचेगी?
ये आपने बहुत अच्छा सुझाव दिया है. जैसा आपको मालूम है, भारत सरकार ने अभी तक हिंदुस्तान में तो कई एक ऐसे नियम बनाए हैं और वरिष्ठ नागरिकों को कई सुविधाएं दी हैं, जैसे कि रेल यात्रा में और बैंक में इंटरेस्ट वगैरह उनको थोड़ा अधिक मिलता है, और इनकम टैक्स में भी उनको थोड़ा एग्जेम्पशन ज़्यादा मिलता है. तो ये भारत सरकार वरिष्ठ नागरिकों का ध्यान रखती है. तो अब आपने ये जो सुझाव दिया है, तो मैं समझता हूँ इसके और भी भारत सरकार ध्यान देगी. तो ये आपने बहुत ही अच्छा किया कि ये एक सुझाव दे दिया. मैं इसको इसमें अपने रिपोर्ट में भी इसका जिक्र कर दूंगा कि इसको भी देखा जाए कि इसके लिए क्या किया जा सकता
है। रिक्वेस्ट मिस्टर बसंत गुप्ता एडिशनल सेक्रेटरी टू आल्सो एड्रेस द गैदरिंग।
वी वर एबल टू डिस्कस विद इंडिविजुअल मेंबर्स, आई थिंक आई शुड शेयर विद ऑल ऑफ यू। वन इज द इशू ऑफ सरेंडर सर्टिफिकेट, दैट इज मैटर ऑफ कंसर्न टू यू। नाउ वन ऑफ द चेंजेस दैट वर मेड लास्ट ईयर वॉज दैट द फीस विच वॉज $175 for getting a surrender certificate was reduced to $20 with effect from 1st June 2010. But there was a representation made by the community saying that the rule should not be made with retrospective effect. So that was one of the changes that was made. Another change that was recently introduced was with regard to the requirement of birth certificate. As you know, in the US passport there is only name, date of birth, place of birth, etc., and the place of issue. It does not have the parentage of the individual. Even then, we said, okay, we'll make the change because there was a feeling that it was causing a lot of anxiety among members of the Indian community. And so we said the submission of birth certificate will no longer be a requirement. Now, these changes were brought into Effect, just a couple of months ago.
जो इंडियन लॉ है उसमें जो NRI की परिभाषा है वो फॉरेन एक्सचेंज लॉ में और इनकम टैक्स लॉ में दोनों डिफरेंट हैं। उससे काफ़ी प्रॉब्लम्स आती हैं लोगों को समझने में, समझाने में। उसको क्या कुछ उसका हल नहीं किया जा सकता?
देखिए, ये जो NRI और जो इनकम टैक्स और वो डेफिनेशन का सवाल है, ये फाइनेंस मिनिस्ट्री डिटरमिन करती है, तो ये एक्सटर्नल अफेयर्स का नहीं है। पर आपके जो व्यूज़ है आप हमें बताइए तो हम दिल्ली ले जाके इसमें ज़रूर जो कंसर्न ऑफिसर हैं उनको कहेंगे कि इसकी जांच करें और इसका देखें क्या हल निकल सकता है।
क्योंकि दोनों ही, चाहे वो इनकम टैक्स एक्ट है चाहे वो फॉरेन एक्सचेंज के लॉ हैं, दोनों ही मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस के अंडर में आते हैं और दोनों में परिभाषा अलग होने से वो कई उसमें प्रॉब्लम्स बहुत ज़्यादा फेस करनी पड़ती।
नहीं, हमें मालूम है कि उसमें रूल्स में कुछ कुछ रेकन्सिलिएशन की ज़रूरत है उसमें जी। तो जो आपके इश्यूज़ हैं वो आप हमें बता देंगे तो हम उनको, जो कंसर्न ऑफिसर को, हम ये अवगत कराएंगे कि इस तरह की ये प्रॉब्लम चल रही है, उसके हल ढूंढने का पूरा कोशिश कर रहे हैं।
यू पिन पॉइंटेड सेवरल ऑफ द इश्यूज व्हिच आर कंसर्निंग द कम्युनिटी एंड आई थिंक दे विल ऑल बी वेरी हैप्पी टू नोट दैट द मिनिस्ट्री इज वेरी एक्टिवली एंगेज्ड इन द टास्क ऑफ फाइंडिंग सॉल्यूशंस टू दीस इश्यूज एंड दीस प्रॉब्लम्स। यू ऑल्सो सेड दैट इन व्यू ऑफ द न्यूअर टास्क व्हिच द कॉन्सुलेट्स आर बीइंग रिक्वायर्ड टू टेक, देयर इज द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ augmentation of strength, and it's very fortunate that we have with us today the additional secretary in charge of administration, because ultimately these decisions cannot be taken without the blessings and the approval of administration. So may I request Mr. Ashok Tomar, who is well known to all of you as a former deputy consul general here, to also address this gathering.
It's good to be back and to see so many old friends. I will not go into so many details about the consular and passport, because passports and visas, because Mr. Ajay Chaudhary, our Consul General, Mr. Prabhu Dayal and Mr. Vasant Gupta have told you what we are planning. We understand what the problems are. As Mr. Dayal mentioned that augmenting the staff strength is an important issue that Mr. Vasant Gupta and I are closely involved in these days. It's not just New York, not just the consulates in US, but many other missions and posts world over we are looking at, and we have a proposal in a fairly advanced stage. I don't want to make any promises just now, but to tell you that we understand the gravity of the situation and we are looking at it very, very seriously. For me, this is a very happy occasion to meet all of you. I left here in end 2005, and I'm happy that the consulate and our friends from the Indian community have not only maintained but developed and strengthened those ties which have existed for so many years, and in fact with some of you in so many decades. And throughout all this, it is known that it's through mutual cooperation and collaboration that we have managed to succeed and to achieve what we have to. What we have done so far, not only in the consular areas, but also in the economic, commercial, the cultural, and other educational areas. And I always, in my other stations, wherever I've been, I've always looked back to New York and marveled at the energy and the sort of strength that is exhibited by the Indian community here.
Well, I hope you enjoyed that. That's all that we have for this week's Week in Review. We'll be back next week with all the news that happened throughout the week. Thank you so much for joining me in this segment. If there's anything that you would like to share with us or with the viewers, any news that you would like us to highlight, you can write to me at madhvi@justbroadcasting.com or you can call me at 718-752-9290. Thank you once again for joining me this week. Stay tuned to Just Punjabi. Sat Sri Akal. Thank you.